Köln.
What's your problem?
Are you okay?
Nothing is okay.
What's the problem?
At this point, nothing seems to make sense anymore. I want to be held, loved, cuddled, caressed. I want to be touched like a woman. And you claim to be my boyfriend. Isn't that one of your duties?
Okay.
Talk.
She looks really nice today, James.
I said talk.
I wasn't expecting to see you anyway.
I thought you said you were sick. But nothing shows you are sick. As a matter of fact, you look fitter than I do. So what was the relevance of that distress call?
I'm a woman, James. With flesh and blood. I have feelings. You can't just get me pregnant and leave me in this godforsaken place with these workers working all the time without giving me time to sleep. And then you go back to the comfort of your home to cuddle your wife.
Now what is the meaning of this?
This means I am no longer a kid, James. Look at me. I am no longer stupid. For Christ's sake, my parents are in the village thinking I am in school. Do you know what? This pregnancy is just a few weeks old. I am going to abort it and delete you out of my mind.
No, you won't abort it.
Yes, I will.
I will not allow you to take that risk. Jesus. I mean,
all right, let's go inside and talk about this. All right?
No, my bed has been cold for a very long time. Why don't you come in and, you know, warm it up? Hmm? Cool. Yes, come in. The door is not locked.
Yeah. Yeah. What have you been? I'm okay. I'm okay. I'm fine.
You got me very worried. And you didn't return any of my calls since morning. I know of your issue with Kwame. I was very worried, to be honest.
Forget Kwame. Then my coming here is rather coincidental. My phone is with the repairer.
I'm changing my screen. I didn't even know you called. Seriously.
Tifa, are you sure you're okay?
I beg, what is cooking? I'm hungry.
You're hungry. Okay, you say so. You're hungry. Well, too bad for you. Because my husband has banned me from going to the kitchen. And guess what? He's gone to the mall to get me chicken wraps and chicken nuggets. I'm sure he'll be preparing pizza later in the day.
Eh? Mm-hmm. Chai! Ah! Love this sweet you.
Allow me to enjoy love. Let me enjoy marriage. Mm-hmm. And you see, the best part is, I wised up and decided to settle. You know how we wanted to tour, have fun and explore before we get married? That was the very difficult part for me. It's like I had to drop some plans. But here I am today, comfortably enjoying my husband's house.
Hey, you know I always tell you how lucky you are to have James.
Mm, of course.
Ah. I remember how you were trying to be hesitant when he was proposing. Now look at you, dripping in love.
My dear, let me. Allow me to enjoy love.
Abel, call James. Call him. Tell him to triple the package. I'm not leaving this house till I'm done eating the food.
Why you bring your empty stomach here to fill it?
Call him. I'll eat before I eat.
Don't worry.
Okay, no problem. Okay.
You know what, babe? I can't seem to get enough of you. I mean, you are simply amazing. And you know I'm already late for my job interview, but to hell with it. I just want to spend the whole day here making your bread.
You are a skilled master, you know. You got to get a coin. You're very talented and lovely. And your skills, oh, damn,
they are second to none. Infant. So wait, so this is where you've been hiding?
Wait, before I talk about
gosh. You know, I've never had a series of orgasms before. But you,
baby, you get hit in the right spot. I felt like exploding.
But you know, I don't actually rush when it comes to lovemaking. And to me, I think every part of the woman's body must be drawn into action. Whilst I'm going inside to prepare you some tea for the status. Then later, I show you some chef's skills.
Oh, shit.
And if you've had enough to eat and satisfy, not to thank you.
This is getting interesting already. Lillian should come and see us.
Speaking of Lillian, when are you bringing her over? I think I told someone would be bad.
You're crazy. Lillian isn't a bad girl. But I, on the other hand, am not ready to share this experience with anybody.
You selfish girl. Okay, so wait here. I'll get you something. I'll be right back.
Okay.
Stop being stubborn. See, the first trimester is always the most difficult part.
If you're not feeling well, let me take you to the hospital. Remember what Dr. Amanda said?
She was very emphatic.
James, it's nothing. Just a slight headache. James, it's nothing. Just slight dizziness and normal headache. We out of stock. I need to go to the market to get full stocks.
Don't worry about that. I will do the groceries. Okay? What I want you to do right now is to be in bed.
Huh? Do you have the list for the things we have to buy?
Just regular vegetables, meats, you know the usual stock. Wait, how are you supposed to be heading to work?
Nothing matters most than your well-being. Huh? I'll find something to tell my boss. I'll make him understand I'll be coming to work late today.
Yeah. One thing you should know. You and the precious baby in here and the world. And I'm not going to compromise you. I'm not going to sacrifice you for even gold. No. Now, stay put right here. And I'll be back.
Don't kill yourself. Please. Alright? Okay. And you need to be in bed by how much?
Okay.
Baby, where did you put the
Okay.
Yasmin. Yasmin, open the door right now. Yasmin!
I'm sleeping! I can't hear you.
You know what, Yasmin? Let's settle this amicably. But if you want to awaken the animal in me, you will not like me. I'm just trying to be a gentleman.
He got! Awaken the he got in you! Womanizer.
That lady is not my lover. I have nothing to do with her. She is not my love, okay? I mean, I have nothing to do with that lady.
Liar.
Just open the door. No. Yasmin!
Oh! Ah! I said I'm sleepy. Find somewhere to relax. Yeah. The sofas are huge enough. Mr. Womanizer.
Yasmin,
3 seconds. Okay. No, it's not 3 seconds. The last time it was 1 minute, 3 seconds. Idiot.
Yasmin! Don't say I didn't warn you. I have been nothing but a good husband to you. I tolerate your nonsense without complaints. Oh, now I see you want to take me for a piece of trash, right? How dare you lock me out of my own bedroom? My own bedroom! Oh, Jesus Christ. You know what? Just stay in there and don't come out. Don't even try. Don't even dare. Because if you do, Yasmin, if you do, I swear to God, I'll crush you!
I see you are a man behind my ear. 30 seconds, man. You can't do anything in bed, only. What's your men? Other men are making their wife cry in bed, like, you'll be hitting it. Punishing them in bed. You can't do anything. Muff, 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 muff. Look at you. Idiot.
I felt it within, but I have no evidence.
You know what, Yasmin? You have to stop addressing me as a cheat, okay? Because I'm not a cheat!
I won't open the door for any cheat. Henceforth, I have banned you from the bedroom. The Bible admonished us never to soil the sanctity of our marriage. You know, I have always had my doubts. The late long meetings, the weekend retreat to other regions. I knew you were doing other women. I knew it, Harry. I felt it within. I felt it within my soul. But I had no evidence.
Oh, the lady you even presume that I'm dating or having an affair with is just a stranger I met from the seminar this afternoon.
No criminal ever admits to their crimes unless they've been threatened. I'm going to show you in this house. You just wait and see.
I'll count up to three. And if you open the door, I will forgive you for trying to poison me. Then we'll talk.
Talk about what? You and I are done talking.
But if you don't...
And if I don't?
You'll regret this.
Oh, I like to regret. No. In fact, don't bother counting.
This door remains shut.
Are you insane?
Yes, I'm mad, Harry.